Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for stopping by. For today's video, we are going to do a Dollar Tree haul. This is just some items that I've been picking up at my local Dollar Tree for probably the last couple of weeks. Where I live, the Dollar Tree is pretty small. We don't have a real big one, and we're usually always the last to get anything at my store. So anyway, these are just a couple items that I picked up. The first item that I got was this berry garland, and it has the white with the green, and then the green has a darker green in it. I have several succulent plant arrangements that I thought this greenery worked into my succulent arrangement would be very, very pretty. And so that's what I got this for, to try to incorporate that into some of my arrangements. The next item I got is from Crafter's Square, and it was really exciting to see this because my store is just starting to expand their Crafter's Square section. We have had one teeny tiny little section at the end of an aisle ever since the store has been there. And so now they are redoing it, and we have like an aisle and a half of Crafter's Square items. So I found these gold foil rub-ons. Rub-on letters. I'm trying to get them where you can see them. And I just thought that they were really pretty and really cute, and for a dollar, because you go to Hobby Lobby and buy these, and I mean, even on sale, you're still going to pay $3 or $4 for them. So anyway, I got those to add to my collection. I do have a Cricut. I just like to keep things like that on hand just for quick. Grab it if you need it in a hurry. Just grab one and finish whatever you're making with it and go on out the door. The next item that I got, we're going to start with the, no, let's do this other item. Forgot about this one. Finally got these no-touch keys at my store. I've been looking for these. I know I've seen a lot of other, people hauling, these keys. And of course, as I said, my store, the last one to get most everything. But I bought like 5 of these, and I bought them, I gave some to my sisters, my mom, my daughter, and actually my little grandson threw a fit for one the other day, so I let him have one. And the other item is just this little home plaque. I thought this was really, really cute. I loved the font on it. I loved the gold. And then it's just kind of, you know, rough around the edges. I really thought this was pretty. I bought this to go in a, like a little inlet on my entertainment center. There's just like a little open space, and that will fit perfectly right in there. So that's what I got that for. Now, moving on to Valentine's Day. This is a set of 3 bags. The first one just looks like this. Says Happy Valentine's Day on it. The second bag is just a solid little red hearts. And the third bag has the pink card on it with the red striped lines. I do need to pick up at least one more bag because I have a daughter and 3 grandchildren to buy for Valentine's Day. So I do have to get one other bag picked up. This, I believe, came from Dollar Tree. It was in my Dollar Tree bag, but this is not a typical Dollar Tree tag. So I'm wondering if maybe it didn't come from Dollar General, but nonetheless, it's only a dollar. And it is this little love bag. It's a like a old toe sack looking, what do you call this? I just went blank. I don't know, fabric bag. I can't think of what it's called. I just lost it. And it has the drawstrings on it. And anyway, the heart here in the middle is like kind of raised a little bit, and it's textured. So that gives it a really neat look. What I plan to do with it is to stuff it with some material from an old pillow that I have around here, and then pull the strings, burlap. That's what it's called. Burlap. Burlap bag. And then tighten up the strings and put a bow with some ribbon made out of this, you know, red checkered, tie a bow around it, and just throw it in one of my patio chairs on the front porch, just to give like a tiny little splash of Valentine's Day on the front porch. I thought that would be cute. The next 2 items I bought for my youngest grandson. They're little heart books. There's 2 different ones. This one is Acts of Kindness and Love, and it just has the cutest little raccoon and skunks and all kinds of little animals in it. It's just so cute. And we've really been working with him on, you know, being kind and showing love, and he's a loving little thing anyway, so, you know, he doesn't have to try very hard, but I thought that would be really cute for him. And then this one, he is in preschool, so this teaches how to count, and that's what he's been working on lately, is his counting and holding up his little fingers and showing you how many numbers it is. And so the hearts, you know, each heart is pulls out, and they get bigger and bigger. I just thought that was really cute. So I got those two to go in his bag for him. The next thing I found, they only had two of these in my store. They had the pink one and the white one. Didn't care for the white one. I can't remember what the tag on the white one said, but I loved pink. I love pink. Pink is my favorite color, so of course I went with the pink. But I actually have this on a tear tray at my coffee bar, so I thought this was really cute. I love the word love. It would be really pretty to stain this too, in my opinion, I think, just to kind of give it a little kick. But anyway, I have some battery-operated tea light candles, and I'm going to put one in here. And like I said, I have it sitting on a tear tray. I thought that would be pretty. And then the next item, or the last Valentine's thing that I have, is this little candle. And it has the little fuzzy, like one of those little fuzzy pom-pom things on top, which is super cute. But it smells really good. Like I don't know, magnolia or something. It smells really, really good. It doesn't have a name of the scent of the candle on it. But anyway, I thought these two together were really pretty. I actually am going to put this on a tear tray too. So I just thought that those were really pretty together. The next item that I got, I was really excited to find, because our Dollar Tree, or my Dollar Tree, never gets these in. I have never been able to find them there. I see them hauled every single year, and they never have them. And it is these little carrots. And so I grabbed a package of these. I know it's still a little ways to Easter, but I knew I would not find them if I did not grab them that day. So I picked up a package. I want to make a little garland with them. I just thought this would be really cute to make a little garland out of it. So that's what I plan to do with that. And then I found these little bunnies on a stick. Aren't they cute? I don't know that I'll leave the sticks this long. I probably will end up cutting them down and just using them either to stick into a couple arrangements just that I have, just to kind of give it an Easter flair, or I may just break them down, like, you know, pretty far and just stick them in my tier trays when I get ready to decorate for Easter. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with these yet, but I just thought they were really, really cute. And then the last item that I was going to show y'all, I picked up like two or three of these last year, and I really liked them, because when I was finished with them, I had this brilliant idea, because I like to, like, my house is kind of farmhouse themed. I thought, how cute would this be to repaint these and make them all year, where they can sit out all year long? So I left them like this. I took the plastic off, of course, but I left them this color for the holidays, for Easter, through Easter. And then once Easter was over, this, I was going to show you guys, this is what I did with them after Easter was over. So I left them in the container, just tied a little bow around them, but I painted them a chalky white color, and then I reflect them with just some black paint, and I put just some moss in it. Anyway, I thought they turned out really cute, and I actually leave them sitting on my stove right there. You can see where they normally sit. So I just leave them out year-round for decoration. So anyway, well, that is all of my Dollar Tree haul for today. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I look forward to making more videos for you guys. And if you would, please be so kind as to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And I just appreciate you for stopping by and watching my video. And I will see you in the next one, guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.